protests in Belarus are sparked by rigged elections, because Sviatlana Tsikhanouskaya won at these elections, and protests were about defending their choice. Majority protested for their votes. In Russia, there was no election that opposition in Russia won. Of course, there are no democratic elections in Russia, we know that, but this is the biggest difference. So in Russia, it's still opposition protests, I would say, and in Belarus, it was the majority protecting its rights. We were trying to learn from other parts of the world, from Hong Kong, for example, especially in terms of tactics, you know, and to see how they do this. We were using same applications on smartphones, you know, this which doesn't need internet, especially when shut down, internet was shut down, you know, to help to connect to each other. But it's, and also we're trying to learn from Gene Sharp and other books, but they were not very helpful because Belarusians invented twice more new practices, you know, of nonviolent resistance. And when we checked the book, we found out that all these tools and ways of protest we already tried and even invented more. So it's quite a technologically driven revolution with a big accent on nonviolent resistance, which helped to engage absolutely new social groups thanks to social media and technologies.